Alright, it is April 17th and it's the middle of the day and we are on Shrub Swamp Interpretive Trail out at Crooked Creek Recreational Area, and it is like 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
I was going to say, I don't know what you consider the middle of the day.
That's the middle of the day.
To me, this is like nearly at the end of the day.
So we are at the lower side of the Crooked Creek Dam. And there's the outflow area coming out of the dam, and then there's the dam there. Pretty big dam. And on the other side of that dam is a big lake and another recreation area over there. And what we're gonna do is hike down this trail here.
We're not camping.
I have my pack on. I don't know if you can see it, but I think I can do it.
Okay.
There we go. Got my pack on here. Just got my gear on that I'm taking with me on the Appalachian Trail. Testing it out. Making sure I got it packed right and the weight's not going to be an issue. Just a test run of my gear and stuff. And then Addie's wearing her pack. Really, she's just got a bunch of water bottles in it.
I've got a sleeping bag stuffed in her bulk at the bottom, and then a bunch of, like, a gallon of water for me and 2 liters for the dogs, just for the weight. And, like, hiking shoes in case I don't like my 5 fingers today.
So, I'm going to let you pass so you can see. She has the North Face Primero 65 liter. It's a female's pack, and it's the female setup. Because it has a female frame and a female harness on there. There is a difference between a male and female harness. Say that again.
I said there's more room for boobs.
Yeah.
And I know it sounds stupid, but like a lot of the chest straps unpacked will go right here, and then there's too much here pushing them up, and they end up under my shin. Yeah. Which is annoying.
Kyle is on his bungee leash. This is a homemade bungee leash that I made for him. You can buy nicer ones on the market, but I made this one from scratch when I lived up in Michigan.
These pink things are spring beauty, and the feathery like leaves back there are Dutchman's breeches, and you can see that there's a few of them, they kind of look like bleeding hearts. The white flowers where my shadow kind of is with the little yellow thing sticking down are Dutchman's breeches. I don't know why. I guess maybe they had like the pockets that would stick up, but I don't know. That's what they are.
I'm testing out my Keen hiking boots, the ones I just bought.
Yay!
Also, and I know that my hiking clothes are good to go. Move it. So I'm not testing out my hiking clothes because I don't really need to. So I'm just wearing my regular clothes. There's some. Rafi, are you sure you haven't been down this trail before?
Here. Kyle, back left here, not here.
Come on, up front. So, just look at the trail now. There's the, I guess it's creek. Pennsylvania has a strange idea of what creeks are because their creeks are awfully large.
Maybe it started out smaller.
Yeah, come on, Kyle.
It's a more mature version of it. The violets are out too.
Everywhere else I've been and hiked around the country, that would be considered a river.
Or a stream. So. Yeah, that's up to river set.
Come on, Kyle.
Oh,
up.
The purple violets are really pretty.
Up front. Up front. Kyle and Ralph have different commands so that I can give Kyle his commands and it won't affect Ralph. Up front. Leave it. Leave it. There we go. It looks like there's some kind of zip line or something across the creek there. Power line or something. We've never been here before. We came here to get my we've been to the park office to get my access pass for the National Forest access pass, which is if you are a disabled veteran, you can go to any national park office and get a free access pass, which gives you free access to all the national parks, and you don't have to pay for parking or any of the a lot of the amenities and stuff are free for disabled veterans. And some of the things you get like 50% off of, some of the things you get for free, and some of the things you get other kind of discounts and stuff for. So, but the main thing I use it for is the parking and the access to the parks. So you don't have to pay, like some of these parks would be like $25 just to enter the park, and then more money to park your vehicle there. And so it can get expensive to visit some of these parks. Like Yellowstone National Park, I think it's like, if I remember right, it was like $15 just to drive your car into the park.
But I'm coping with a lot of visitors, and they do. Yeah.
But with the access pass, for if you're a disabled veteran, then you don't have to pay that fee to go into the park. So it's pretty cool. If I remember, I'll show you the card and what it looks like when we come out of the trail. And there's also other ways that you can get the access pass as well. If you are certified by the state as physically disabled, I think you can get it that way also. Just having a disabled placard does not get you the access pass. You have to have your doctor's certification and a whole bunch of other stuff to get it, so.
And some places aren't clued up about it yet, so you may have to be informed.
Yeah.
You can inform them and bring your information.
Yeah, like North Carolina, they pretend that they don't know anything about it, and they'll try to say, oh, we don't know anything about the access pass, and we have no way of providing the discounts or the punching it into our computer. And I'm like, well, it doesn't matter. It's a national thing, so you have to accept it anyway. So you got to figure it out. But anyways, I'm going to guess that these were some kind of zip line things at one point in time.
Like rescue?
Yeah, like some kind of zip line thing that they ran stuff back and forth across the creek.
Well, this is also an Army Corps of Engineer area. Like yeah. They may have used it for some other zip line training or something.
Yeah. Well, a zip line doesn't necessarily mean that they ran people back and forth.
Right, no, I'm just saying it might have been some sort of training equipment sort of thing. White violets, purple violets, trout lily, leaves at least, trillium leaves, hobo leaves.
All right. Well, we'll show you what Addie found, and then we'll turn the camera off, and we'll talk to you later.
Trout lily, the yellow one. You'll see it better from my side. Oh, hey, there's more. It's just blocking
the trout. Kyle, you're standing on the trout lily. So if I put this on my fishing pole, I'll catch a trout.
I don't think so. I think it might be because it's trout season. Like,
okay.
When the trout, or it could be like the leaves are kind of that speckled color that looks kind of like a trout died. I just know what a trout lily.
Okay. Alright, we'll talk to you later. Okay, we finished our hike and we came back, and I'm down here at the water, and I'm going to test my, well, I've been testing my waterproofness of my shoes. I haven't done anything to them yet as far as putting waterproofing on it, so they're as they came in the store. And I've been sitting here for about a minute, maybe 2 minutes now, doing what you see me doing here, submersing them about halfway up the shoe, keeping them submersed and squishing them back and forth. These are my Keens. And
with Keen Dry.
With the Keen version of Gore-Tex. And my socks are dry so far. I don't feel that. I feel the shoe's getting cooler. Like the temperature is getting cooler, but I do not feel them getting wetter.
Can you
take Droppy away? So they're staying dry. Even the cloth portion. See if I get my trekking pole here. The cloth portion where my trekking pole is touching.
Changing color.
It's changed color, but it's not seeping through.
Give it some.
So we'll see over time. But the other portion here, I'm not feeling any wetness yet. I have my doubts about that cloth portion staying dry.
Right.
But the leather part, I think the leather part will stay dry. They usually do.
And they probably do really well even with that fabric if you had just stuck the foot into it and then kept walking.
And I think, however, with the tests I've done here, I pretty much guarantee they're going to stay dry in a rain.
Yeah.
I don't think they were designed, no shoe is designed for complete submersion like I'm doing here.
Unless
and
like
staying
boots.
There. Yeah, the hiking boots are not designed to be submerged like this and just stand there in the water like I'm doing. So this is like an extreme test as far as I'm concerned. And swishing around, I'm trying to make them leak. I'm trying to get them to leak, and it's not working. Not yet. So now we'll have the soak-in test and see how long, if my socks get wet from them drying out now. And if they do, we'll find out. But I can't get them any wetter than I just did.
Butterfly.
So. We'll see when I take the shoes off. My socks still feel dry. I'm wearing cotton socks on the inside at the moment.
Oh, cotton.
But they are. It looks like they're drying out already.
It's too hot out. It's like 60 something.
No, it's
something.
80.
What?
82 degrees.
I'm gonna die. No wonder.
82.4 degrees Fahrenheit right now.
I like the cave across the street.
But yeah, they're already starting to dry out.
No wonder Ralph and I are like melted.
So,
my wet puppy.
I think this is going to work for waterproof. And probably I'll save my knit wax and use those on my old shoes. But yeah, this shoe here feels warmer than this shoe. This shoe here cooled off a lot faster than the other one did.
But tighter, maybe?
We're just talking about the thermal portion. So. I like that sign there. When horn sounds, beware of rapid change in water level. Basically, if you hear the horn sound, get the hell out of Dodge. Ralphie's enjoying the water. Don't go any further to the left, Ralph. I think there's some fishing hooks over there.
Ralphie, that is a big rock. Did you see him bite the rock?
I saw him lick it.
No, he licked it, then he bit like he was going to bring it back in for me. I love you, buddy. You don't have to bring me jewelry. Come on, buddy. Shake it.
What you doing, Kyle? You want to go over here?
This is just wrong. You shouldn't be there like that.
Go over here, Kyle.
Watch Ralph. Come here, Frank. There's fishing line over here, too, but I haven't.
Where there's fishing line, there's generally a hook. Can you fix Kyle's leash? Let's go up those staircase over there, if we... Come on, Kyle. Up.
Take it easy, Ralph.
Go slowly, Kyle.
I have no grip, and there is a lure right there. Yeah.
Don't pull me down, Kyle.
Wow, this water is definitely like...
cold?
It's, I think it's 50 degrees. It's nice. I'm liking it.
Woo! Thought I saw another lure over here. Oh, just
stuff.
Green. Ready to go up some stairs, Kyle? Staircase. Nope. Over here, Kyle.
Up. Stairs.
On the stairs. Kyle, over here. Over here. There you go. Right there that makes the rapid. Probably some kind of concrete wall or something right there.
I think possibly also the fact that it opens out. This water is coming back around.
It says the underwater gate right there. So this is the access pass I was talking about earlier, and it's for national parks and federal recreational land pass, lifetime pass for U.S. citizens and permanent resident medically determined to have a permanent disability that severely limits one or more major life activities, and basically it's a free pass. You get if you have a debilitating injury, such as the spinal damage that I have, or a debilitating illness or something like that. So it gives you the ability to come in and use the parks and stuff like that. So. You can look it up online, just punch in national parks and then go to any of the national park websites and then go into look up the access pass or entrance fees and stuff like that. And when you get into entrance fees, look on the access passes. It just goes into what I already showed.
Okay.
So, but all right, just wanted to show that real quick. And they give you a little placard that you hang in your rearview mirror, and you slip this into the little placard. Or you just leave it on your dash like that when you go in and park. But, all right, we're going to take off.
Back up some.
Ralphie's favorite little spot is laying right there.
He likes.
Kyle's over there. And Addie's there.
I'm still here.
And we're off to go home.
The camera.